Hello everyone. I'm Svetlana from Perth, Western Australia, and I'm talking here about perfumery. And looking at me now, you can guess what I will be talking about. One, two, three, four, five. Of course, we'll be talking about fragrances from Jean-Paul Gaultier. Jean-Paul Gaultier is a French fashion designer who issued his first fashion collection in 1976. He was supported by Pierre Cardin and Pierre Cardin and Jean Patou. So what he was doing without a formal education in fashion, he was sending his designs to the famous fashion house. And this is how Pierre Cardin and Jean Patou found him. And Pierre Cardin liked him so much that he sent him to his Manila shop to manage it when in a very young age. Generally, he was considered as an enfant terrible, horrible, terrible, terrible child of the fashion industry, and you all may remember him. He was first who dressed men in the skirts. Of course, the first who dressed men in the skirts was Scottish people. So he stole this idea and made it haute couture, yeah, hot fashion, high fashion. Also, you all remember the singer Madonna, American singer. She was wearing his costumes in her 1990 world tour, and you all remember this con bra she was wearing. It's a staple of the music industry at the moment, so everyone remember the beautiful French corsets. I'm not wearing it today. I don't think my beauty suits a corset, or corset suits my beauty at the moment. I'm not young enough. And marinière style, which is a marine style which he first introduced in a collection Boy Toy. You know this expression, toy boy is like a younger man who entertains older partner, yeah, or wife or husband. Yeah, wife or husband. And if you look at the Jean-Paul Gaultier photos online, you will find that he mostly wears all the time like this marine style top. Yeah, this is why I'm wearing it, and this is why I'm wearing it. A few years ago, you may see the his collection with Gigi Hadid, the American model, very beautiful girl in this style. Hat and a very beautiful pleated top, which is like a fan, like pleated fan. Find it in the Google, Gigi Hadid and Jean-Paul Gaultier. I think her picture will stay in the fashion industry. So I think it was enough, yeah, for me. I'm not a Gigi Hadid. Yeah, I wish to be as beautiful as her. Also, is famous about his tins for perfumes. His packages are not in normal, not all of them, but most of his perfumes are not in normal cardboard packages. They are in metal tin. Yeah. So not just him did it. So I know who else, like Salvador Dali did it as well, and probably even earlier than Jean-Paul Gaultier. So he's from the family of the middle class. His father was a clerk in the government office, as far as I understand, and mom was also a servant. Middle class family. What else he's famous about? When he was in Manila, he was serving Imelda Marcos, the wife of the Philippine dictator Marcos. Probably he sold her one of her 6,000 shoes she had in her collection. He also was successful when he was a creative director of Hermes House, one of the top French fashion houses, producing most expensive leather stuff and scarves. I was wearing the Hermes scarf for my Russian video for this, but I think it was a little bit too much, so I will not be doing it. You also may remember the movie The Fifth Element, yeah, with Bruce Willis and Mila Jovovich. And you may remember all these funky costumes. These costumes actually were designed for the future. The movie, it was issued in 1997, and if I am not wrong, the future was in 2022, 2023, which means about how many years? 20 years later, yeah. So very close to where we are now. We are not wearing these costumes yet. We're actually going to the simpler fashion, I think, more casual than it was, say, 20 years ago. So he made about 1,000 costumes for that movie, and according to his colleagues, he normally does 5 sketches for each costume. So he done around 5,000 sketches for the costumes. He himself evaluates this job as like making 10 seasonal fashion collections. And we have 2 collections every year, summer, winter, or spring and summer, autumn and winter. And it means like to make 5 years job of creative director of any fashion house. So I am sure that my generation watched this movie. It's 100%. It's one of the staples of the movie industry. And if you are younger, I'm not so sure. It's still worth to watch. It's a young Bruce Willis, very beautiful people, interesting story to tell. And for me, the most impressive costume was the costume for the radio host, which was a full leopard, like with open open shoulders, and the hairstyle white with like I will not tell what it looks like. Yeah, you all understand. And have a look. So, and remember that orange is a most favorite color of Jean-Paul Gaultier. So the Lilou, the main actress Mila Jovovich, had a orange carré style, and she was wearing also white and orange, and Bruce Willis was wearing orange in this movie a lot. Impressive costumes, impressive. And why I'm talking about that for so long, because this aesthetic of the brand made a lot of influence on the aesthetic of the fragrances. And I would say that there were about 8 main fragrances by Jean-Paul Gaultier since 1993, a lot of Lancers, and this started in 1993 with a fragrance classic for women, and it was a Le Male, it's hard to say it in French, I'm not successful, I tried many times, still not right. Le Male, which is mean man, which was the masculine version of Classique. Then it was a Fragile for females. Gaultier 2, 2005, it was a unisex fragrance. Then 2008 it was a Madame, and the same year it was a Monsieur, and in 2011 was issued Cocorico was issued. It was a male fragrance, and it was balanced in 2017 by Scandal. So now I'll go through each of them separately. I will start with Classique, which was issued for women in 1993. And here I have a set which I bought just, I don't know why, I just wanted to have this one because I already had a Fragile, but by the time I don't really like Classique a lot. Le Male is a male fragrance, and I bought this set because of this fragrance. And I was about opening it a while when my perfume friend told me, "Don't open it. I'll give you this one." Separately as a gift. So you know, when people are deep in the perfumery, I'm not only one. I know other people. They tend not to open fragrances packages without a need. It's not about resale or anything. It's more about like a pristine collection item. So when it's unpacked, it has a higher value for collection than when it's packed. It has a higher value for collection when unpacked. Not because you can sell it for more, because it's a pristine thing, you know, new. Apologies, I'm not going to open it without the need. And this is Classique. And this fragrance was made by by Jacques Cavalier, one of my favorite perfumers. And it still was the early 90s, and at that time perfumes were made in an old school way. It's now when you can find a perfume with three notes, and it was not the case at that time. So this perfume has a lot of notes. I'll just tell you what are the main notes, what I feel. For me, it's a vanilla, orange blossom. I feel them very strong, and ylang ylang. Also, in the bottom notes, it has a amber, it has a musk, it has a sandalwood, it has cinnamon, but they are not the dominating notes. In the middle notes, it also has a ginger, orchid flower, iris, tuberose, and plum, but they're also not dominating notes. And on the top notes, there is a star anise. Probably, yes, you can feel it a little bit stronger than other notes after orange blossom, rose, mandarin orange, pear, and bergamot. And perfume is very well blended. You cannot really say, "Oh, now I feel that, now then I feel another thing." No, for me, it's a predominantly vanilla, amber, and orange blossom. And it's so sweet for me that I cannot wear it. It's very cloying, and I get tired of it very quickly. And I also have a headache. So, at the same time, when I feel it on someone else, it's fine for me. I don't have a headache, and for me, it's beautiful on others, but not on myself. What else I need to tell? It has a rather high score on Fragrantica. It's 3.9 plus out of 9,000 notes, which is quite a high score for a fragrance with so many votes. I'll talk about this more when we talk about Le Male. That's basically it. It's one of the best-selling fragrances. It's very recognizable bottle. A lot of flankers were issued, a lot. So if you look at the list of flankers, it's almost every year a flanker, and sometimes two, because sometimes they made a summer edition. Full size bottom from this line, I only have one, and this is summer 2013. It's a little bit lighter than original classic, and bottle is very beautiful. And have a look, it looks for me like the tattoo, yeah. And tattoo in the Asian style, maybe Japanese style. There is a fish which name is koi, and often this flanker is called koi flanker 2013. I expected that it might be a little bit easier for me to digest, and yes, a little bit less dense fragrance. It's more summery. And when I bought it, I asked a woman who sold it to me why she's selling it, and she told me it causes me a headache. By the time I was at home, it caused me headache. It's a little bit more powdery and fresh than the original, but still I cannot wear it, and I only appreciate it because of a bottle. Also, you notice that many Jean Paul Gaultier fragrances don't have a cap. They're just like this. We are moving to the next one. And next one is Le Male, which I cannot pronounce correctly in French. And this fragrance was a fragrance of Francis Kurkdjian, who made it in 1995. And it also has a 3.9 score on Fragrantica, but among 10,000 worlds. So, Classic was issued in 1993 for females and attracted 9,000 votes, and Le Male was issued in 1995, 2 years later, and attracted 10,000 votes. So, who loves perfumery more, male or female? It might be another effect because women have more options. So. Male don't really have as many options as female. This fragrance made Francis Kurkdjian famous, according to some writers about perfumery. Not so sure, but really he was very, very young at that time. And the design of this bottle reminds you the male body, and if you look at the flankers, they're fantastic. I love the flankers, both Classic and Le Male. In Classic now, the latest one I've seen in the shops is in the red bottle with a very beautiful necklace around, and the core seems they change the quality of glass. They definitely change the shape. It's much more modern with like a more prominent lines, more defined lines, more like artificial than natural human body. Le Male has a like a fig list in where in this area, very funky design which reflects the character of Jean Paul Gaultier as an and his emploi of the enfant terrible in fashion. Some say it was quite a new direction in the male's perfumery because at that time issuing the sweet fragrance, sweet vanilla for male was not quite quite a massive things to do. It was a pioneering, and some say it's fresh, some say it's a too sweet vanilla, some say it's too much cinnamon, some feel dough in there, some say it's a dirty meat with Georgia mint with lavender. So all people have different opinions, but still high score and one of the best selling fragrances at the moment. And it's almost 20 years later. No, even 30 years later, yeah? 2023, it will be 30 years. It's half of life somewhere. So, that's about this. And now, we are moving to the next one. And then 2000 millennium, yeah. And Jean-Paul Gaultier issues a fragrance, Fragile. Jean-Paul Gaultier is famous by using the our daily consumer aesthetic in hot couture, in a high fashion, and what fragile means. So according to the brand, it means the stamp which is made on the boxes when boxes are shipped, and this imitates this stamp fragile. I think it's quite a contrast with the bottle represents, with a really fragile woman inside the globe with sparkles, yeah. This is a hemisphere, yeah, sort of the hemisphere. And I also seen it's an eau de parfum, 50 milliliters. I also seen it in the like a full globe, almost the Christmas type globe. I even know where you can buy it, but I will not tell you because I want to buy it myself. So now we are spraying it. The author of this fragrance is, it's sometimes work has issues with spraying, yeah. For me, this is old school tuberose. Author is Francis Kurkdjian as well. I don't know if he participated in in creation of this bottle, but actually this fragrance is not fragile. It's quite a strong tuberose, and for me tuberose is something quite quite dominating. It's like a dominatrix woman. For me myself, I am not that dominating. I am more subtle and flexible, and the strong tuberose normally is the alpha female, alpha dog, yeah, alpha bitch. That's why it's often called, like, if you want, the Dior Poison is a tuberose fragrance as well. Here, how is different? It also has a lot of notes, but the main note is tuberose. But because it has a lot of notes, like in the base note, it has a amber, vanilla, musk, cinnamon, cedar. And the middle nose, it also has a jasmine, ginger, lanolin, carnation, rose, and iris. And top notes are orange blossom, ginger, tangerine, star anise, coriander, Bulgarian rose, and bergamot. It's very well blended. You can say it's a tuberose in a very beautiful frame of other notes. However, I cannot say which notes they are. It's like a old school many notes, which smells very classy. It means classy from what English people use when they say classy. It means high class, and which is not really screaming of anything. No wealth, no, like, it's humble because they know their value themselves, yeah. So if you don't like tuberose, it's probably not for you. I bought this fragrance just because of the bottle and because it has a collectible value, and of course I wanted to try it. Everyone wants to try what's inside, what's the juice inside the bottle, of course. Thank you. And moving to the next one. And next one, I was talking about it in the previous video. It was Gautier II. Also Francis Courgeard. It's 2005, and this is first unisex fragrance from this house. And it's a beautiful bottle. And if you find the full bottle in a proper edition where there are two fragrances for him and for her, I understand they are the same, but they also can be like a put together back by back. I want to buy this version, but it's a little bit too expensive. I am so far happy with what I have, and I think this fragrance is a confirmation of Francis Courgeard geniosity, like he is genius, yeah, because it's made from just not so many notes. It's amber, vanilla and citrus, and it's blended so well and so beautiful that even me, who doesn't like the amber vanilla citrus, yeah, citrus is okay, amber is okay, vanilla is okay, but together most of fragrances of this type I cannot appreciate. I don't like them. They are like sticky for me. This is not sticky. This is not warm. This is coolish, cold, like a coolish cold, yeah, not too cold, not distant, but it's quite a neutral for temperature wise. And it's really unisex. Male and female can wear it. You can wear it in even in any season. Of course, in summer you can wear something fresher, but if you really love it, it would not cloy anyone. And you can wear it for event, for office, at home, to the bed, for the date, in winter, in autumn, in spring. It's beautiful. Yeah. That said, that they don't sell it anymore. I want to buy a full bottle at a normal retail price, not a resale rare discontinued fragrances price. And another one which I talked about in my vanilla videos is Gautier II Eau d'Amour, and this is limited edition. It's more feminine, and you can see it in the design. It's like a nice name, and also little hearts. And I was saying about it in the previous video, it's very sexy, but sexy in a very clean and innocent way. It's an innocent sexy, and young as well. So it's like a blonde girl with, I don't know why, with curls, curly, and wearing like Victoria's Secret lingerie in her bedroom, with like a cream and rose colors and laces, and she likes herself. She doesn't have any worries in her life yet, so really nice, clean and sexy. Clean and sexy. And this one is not as expensive as the original Gautier II. You still can buy it at a pretty reasonable, almost retail price on eBay. You see, it's like a heart, it's a black heart with number one, which is the lowest card in cards, so me, it's young, yeah, lowest one. Thank you very much. And the next one is a female as well, female fragrance as well, which was issued in 2008 or 2010. It's hard to say because various sources say different things about it. And this is Madame, and it has this stopper like in the bomb. And you may recall another fragrance Agent Provocateur. They use it in the bottles. I don't know who started it first. I will check later when I will talk about Agent Provocateurs. This fragrance they call Floral Shipper. I a little bit disagree, but it's mostly because of my own classification of what shipper means. For me, shipper fragrance is a fragrance which contains oak moss, labdanum, or any other balsamic notes, and bergamot, and it can be other stuff. Other stuff on top, in the middle, or everywhere. They call it sometimes floral shipper, or fruity shipper, or leather shipper. They call it shipra. So I disagree that this is a shipra in understanding in a like old school definition, because this fragrance doesn't contain neither oak moss nor balsamic notes, nor bergamot. In the bottom lines, it has a musk, cedar, and patchouli. In the heart, it has a rose. On it, in the top notes, it has pink pepper and orange. And this one, I will spray it now. For me, it is a fragrance which is a fashion of the time. It's rose patchouli, and often people compare this fragrance with Midnight Poison from Christian Dior. And if you have a Midnight Poison, you may remember Midnight Poison as a very dark patchouli and gothic rose, very very dark, almost non-sweet. This one is a bit sweeter because of orange and pink pepper. This is lighter and sweeter, but it's not as loud as another similar fragrance from Yves Saint Laurent, Elle. So this is much lighter. I think this rose is a bit sweeter. I actually like it more and more because this rose is nice. It's not too jammy. It's nice rose. When you buy it, don't confuse it with, this is Eau de Parfum, don't confuse it with Eau de Toilet. Because now I'll talk about Eau de Toilet. I don't know who is a perfumer for this fragrance. I couldn't find the name, unfortunately. I assume this is Francis Kurkdjian as well, but I might be wrong. I don't remember Francis Kurkdjian making patchouli roses like this. Maybe someone else. And the Eau de Toilette with the same name, Madame, was issued in 2008, and I would say it's a completely different fragrance. This one smells for me like plastic citrus, sweet plastic citrus. It actually associates with this color for me as well. This is exactly how synthetic it smells. However, what Fragrantica say, the idea of the perfumer, who is Francis Kurkdjian, was to make a note of grenadine liqueur. Obviously, it is a note of some sort of alcohol, but only after you know it. If you don't know it, it will probably smell you something plastically citrus. I also had the two colleagues who complimented me on two different dates, and they didn't really compliment any other fragrances on me. So seems some people, and I asked one, what does it smell? I asked one of them, and he said it smells like very expensive shop. So you know that we all, our olfactory perceptions are different, and we, that's why we like different things. Our life experience brings it, where we were grown, in which culture, what was the nature around, so a lot of things. And seems some people really like it. And don't listen my words that I don't like it, don't take them seriously. If you have a chance to test, test it. And I would say it's yeah, expensive shop, probably this is something which would reflect this quite an artificial thing. Maybe for some it smells more modern. It's not just a simple nature notes. No, it's not. It's something like what is currently in fashion, not in 2008. So yes, 2008, almost more than 10 years ago. So now they like adding these purposely artificial notes. And I, from one hand, we are moving towards the more environmentally friendly life, yeah, but environmentally friendly life may cause us using and reusing synthetic materials more. Because if you don't want to touch the nature and abuse the nature, you need to derive your materials for your life from somewhere else. That's why you may hear the fragrances like Fantomas from Nazumato. It smells plastic. If you look at the L'Artisan Parfumier collection, Explosions, Emotions Explosions, yeah, they all have this artificial note, like something artificial material note. Now smell better after some time. So don't confuse them. This is two completely different fragrances. This is not the lighter version of that. It's two completely different fragrances. Don't confuse them. That's important. Thank you very much. And I am moving to the next one, which name is Monsieur. Monsieur, and the official name is Eau de Du Matin, which is water of the morning, morning water. Yeah, and you see how beautiful it is. It's like a brick design in a bottle. This one was issued in 2008, and can you guess who is the perfumer? Perfumer. Yes, of course, Francis Kurkdjian. And 2008, and this is a cologne for men. Morning water, of course, this is a cologne. And it's quite interesting because it contains citruses notes, bergamot, the some woody notes, green notes, and a little bit of spice, a little bit, just I cannot say it's a masculine, completely masculine. I think it's a unisex, and it's a non-sweet unisex. They compare it with Mugler cologne and 4711, but those two, they contain a neroli note, which normally adds a little bit of sweetness to the fragrance, and this doesn't have it. So it's more, it's greener and drier, a little bit drier. It's not as sweet as Mugler cologne or Neroli Portofino, but it's a good replacement. I think it's fantastic for the warm weather. Today we have a little bit coldish weather in Perth, but and raining here. I think I will take it to wear during this summer. It's really good. I just have a little bit left, yeah. I got it in one of the bulk fragrances because I bought one because of something. I don't remember now. And just got it together. Yeah. Really, really good cologne. Not expensive, fantastic bottle. So, men, if colognes with Nerolis are a bit too sweet for you, or you are looking something cheaper, this is a replacement. And this from Francis Kurkdjian, whose other fragrances in his own line are very expensive. So let's call it Kurkdjian cologne. Okay, going to the last two in this video, but I will mention number three as well. And the year 2011, opening, finally we found the tin. We were talking about aesthetic of the brand. This is metal tin, and this is how it looks like in a very soft material, like a sponge, thick sponge. We have a bottle, and the bottle is a black head with a red name, Cocorico, and gunmetal color atomizer. And have a look. I put it here. This face reminds me. I don't know why American Indian. I don't know why. It may remind you someone else, but I think this nose type of nose is something very special, and not many nationalities have it. This is a male fragrance, and I will spray it. It has a flanker. I don't have a flanker. Why I bought it? Because I really, it's interesting, because for this designer, I have all the men fragrances without even thinking about it. It just happened. Like Le Male was in the set, and Monsieur was in the bulk buy, and this one I bought purposely. I bought it purposely because of the cacao note. I was looking for cacao note. Or cocoa, yeah, cacao, and this is mainly cacao and patchouli fragrance. And when I tried it for the first time, it reminded me a fragrance, Iris Celadon from Armani, which is a chocolate patchouli, chocolate powder patchouli fragrance. This one is a little bit softer because the Iris Celadon is almost like a basement of the serial killer, fragrance. It's very cruel, very distant, very cold, very dry, very dusty. This is a little bit softer. It's like probably a mezzanine of the serial killer. It has a fig leaf on top, but it doesn't have a fig leaf smell. I really do not like figs in perfumery. I love figs. I adore figs. Fig fruits, fig trees, and smell of the leaves, but not in fragrances. I don't want to wear fragrances with the fig leaves. It's for me too culinary. And middle notes are cacao and patchouli, as was promised, and in the bottom there are vetiver and cedar, and this vetiver and fig leaf, they make it a little bit juicy, a little bit greener than Iris Celadon, so it's a softer version, and cedar makes it a little bit masculine. I would say that this is not a feminine fragrance at all, but can a woman wear it? I think yes. So I would wear it, no problems. I like sometimes sweet fragrances, but mostly I like non-sweet fragrances, and this one is very dry. It's like a coffee, espresso coffee, in the perfumery. without sugar, without milk, maybe a little bit milky than Iris Celadon. Iris Celadon I would compare with Ristretto coffee, which is very strong, and this one espresso. Yeah, one shot. So as a woman, I would wear it. I probably what I will do now, I will just use it for myself, for sprays, yeah. And I will wear it tonight and see how I feel in this and where I would wear it if, as a female. Girls, if you are looking for dark cocoa, non-sweet, dry, dark chocolate, this is it, yeah. And still not very expensive. I understand it's been discontinued or discontinued. So you still can buy it cheap, but you may not have this chance later in your life. The only problem, I think you cannot see how much is left. I bought a new bottle, so it's full, but if you buy, you cannot see how much is left if it's not the new. Well, this is a beautiful tin. I really like it. Red tin. And the last one, which actually I was lying to you, it was the last one. And the last one I want to mention is a Scandal fragrance. The name is Scandal, with two legs on a bottle like this, yeah, in the shoes. It was issued in 2017, but it, I cannot talk about this fragrance because I tried to use it. I had a little samples and I tried it in the shops. It's too sweet for me. It's too cloying for me. I cannot wear it. I think it's for someone more feminine than me. I don't find myself like on the scale from 0 to 100% femininity. I am not on this at this range or this 100% here. I'm not here. So I'm more like if we take a very soft, very gentle woman, full of love, and it's like, oh, no, it's not me. I'm a bit more practical and a bit. cynical sorry, yeah. And I think Scandal is for such girls who are, or either girls who are very very sexy, you know, like a super vamp type with like everything, with a cobra. thank you very much for watching. And if you watch the movie Fifth Element, tell me what you remember about the costumes. I really like that movie, Multi-Passport and things like this. And if you have any fragrances of Jean-Paul Gaultier, which I mentioned in this video, share your thoughts with me. I will be really pleased to receive comments and reply to them. I'm not seeking for likes, dislikes, subscriptions. If I feel like if you people feel they need it, please do it. But just don't be lazy. Only do things when you feel a need to do it. But comments I am seeking for, because this is the reason why I'm doing it. I want to share my hobby and I want to talk about this. I want to hear opinions. I want to hear jokes. Thank you. Bye.